Hope you are doing good. This is Dr. Sandhiya, Assistant Professor of English. Today we are here to tell you, to give you some tips to get through your university semester examinations of general English, that is foundation English, and major literature papers, English papers. So some tips, because you are struggling to, most of the students, those who have the Tamil medium background, those who have rural background, struggle to get through your English papers, semester English papers. And literature students also, they are in literature class, BA English literature class, and some students, they have a Tamil medium background, so they struggle to get through your exams. So I'm here to give you some tips and some tactics, methods, okay, so to get through your university semester examinations. So this is the topic we are going to see today. Tips to get through the university semester examination for two categories of students. Who are the two category of students? Categories of students. One is general English and other one is major literature students. So general English students, major literature students, how to get through your exams. As you, we have so many days to prepare for our university examination due to this crisis we are facing today. So I'll give you some tips to get through the exam. First of all, we'll see the general English paper, foundation English, general English for first year and the second year students. You are in second semester, your subject code is CLZ 2K for arts, CLZ 2L for science students, and this is for arts students. Your question paper pattern is first 15, 1 mark question, so this is your pattern. For general English students, first year students, CLZ 2K and CLZ 2L for science and arts students. So those are arts students which become students, ECS students. So you have this CLZ 2K and 2L. What is the difference between 2K and 2L? Arts students, this semester you will get arms and the man, or extra drama, arms and the man. Science students, you won't get that. Okay, your syllabus, this is the only portion science art students will get. So this is your pattern, 15 into 1, 15 marks, 4 into 5, 20 marks. This is 1 mark questions, and this is paragraph question, and this is essay question. So what is the pattern? So 15, 1 mark question, you just leave it, that I tell you later. Paragraph question and a essay question. So 4 plus 4 altogether need to study only 8 essays. Out of 16 essays we have, lessons we have. We have 16 lessons. Unit 1 prose, poem, short stories, one act plays. Unit 1 we have prose. We have prose, 4 lessons, poetry. We have 4 short stories. We have 4 one act play. We have 4, and arms and the man, and the man, 1. So out of this is, out of 60, you are going to study only 8 essays. Out of 8 essays, how to select this 8 essays? That is the one I am going to tell. If you study this 8 essays properly, it is very easy to get through your exams. For example, prose. We have 4 prose. Refugee, Lion and the Lamb, Lady and the Tiger, Sky is the Limit. What is the importance of these 4 essays? Sky is the Limit, you already studied in your early classes about Kalpana Chawla. So, no need to study this one. Out of 16, we are going to study only 8 essays. In that 8 essays, what are the 8 essays you have to select to study from prose? Refugee, Lion and the Lamb, Lady and the Tiger, Sky is the Limit. These are all the 4 essays which is 4 essays prescribed in your syllabus. Out of 4, Sky is the Limit, which you already studied in your early classes. So Sky is the Limit is about Kalpana Chawla and her education, her family background, and her 2 times she traveled to Milky Way. So these are all the things you, as you studied in your early classes, you can, you know this lesson very, you can study very easily. So that is the one you can study, that is optional. If you know, you can go for that. I'll tell you. So what are the lessons you have to select easily? First, in prose, we have 4 prose, 4 poetry, 4 short stories, 4 one-act plays. And for design art students, arms and the man. Arms and the man, it is a compulsory question, the last option. For example, if the 5th A and B, it's like a either or question you will get, and the last question in the essay also, paragraph also, you will get last option from arms and the man, and the last essay question also, you will get the essay question also, you will get the same question. So arms and the man, it is a compulsory question for the arts students, CLS 2K students. So this essay you have to study compulsory. How to study summary of the arms and the man? Arms and the man is a story about a love story, war and love. War and love. So between war and love. This is a summary of that story, theme of the story. So just remember the characters. What is the theme of the story? Sequence of the story, events of the story. So based on this, if for example, if you see any cinema sanda, you can easily narrate the story to your friend, Sai Machana in the padam pate, like that, you can easily tell that story, no? So in the recently, if you see any films and all, you can easily narrate the story. The same way, just listen the story from your friends. Those who know the story very well, listen the story very carefully, then you just rewrite as you understand the story. How to rewrite? I don't know English, ma'am. I don't know how to write English. My English is very poor. How to write? Don't worry about that. Simply listen the story, read the story from the notes. You have notes, get your notes from your class tutor, that class tutor or English teacher. Read the story 1 or 2 times. Whether you understand the meaning, whether you are able to read it properly, don't bother about that. Okay, so what you have to do? You read the story 1 or 2 times. How to read the story? Very slowly, just read. Slowly in the sense, loudly. Not slowly in the sense, not within mind, but school everybody. It's not like that. Okay, so you have to read the story loudly, slowly, then 2-3 times you just read it. Then you can easily understand the concept, how the order, okay, the sequence or the events, characters, everything. That you reproduce in the essay. So 2 pages essay, 2 pages, you know the, your examination paper. Okay, so your examination semester answer script, you know, in that 2 pages is more than enough for an essay. Okay, for paragraph 1 page or half of the page, 1 or half of the page is more than enough for a paragraph. Okay, so that also. So 2 questions. 1 essay question, 1 paragraph question. Okay, so 1 essay and 1 paragraph. So how much mark? Out of 15. So 15 mark you can get 1 essay, arms and the man. Fine. Next, 1 act play, short story, poetry and prose. How many essays I told you to study? 8 essays out of 16 essays. 1 arms and the man got over. Remaining 7 essays are there. So what are the 7 essays? How to select the 7 essays? So select the essays. How to select? First, from prose. From prose, what are the lessons are there in prose? First one is refugee. I believe you all study refugee. Manji lesson. You all, I know, prose. First, Manji lesson. Okay, for the partition between Pakistan and India. So that lesson you all studied, I believe that, because from the beginning you are studying for CAT 1, CAT 2 and model exam, you are studying that. So that one exam is lesson. Second one is lion and the lamb. Third one is lady and the tiger. Sky is the limit. Sky is the limit, as I told you. That is, sky is the limit. As you studied in your early classes, that you can select. Or lady and the tiger, lion and the lamb. Lady and the tiger is a very interesting story. You all studied, you are learned very interestingly, because again it is a love story. Okay, so it's an open-ended story, either a lady or a tiger. So which one is your option, the lady or the tiger? So depends upon your concept towards love, you can choose that. Okay, so that is, so select story based story, that means in essence, that is lion and the lamb, lady or the tiger, these are story based. How you are listening some stories, or how you see the cinemas and all, it's a story based. So like that you select the prose or poetry or whatever it is, the essays, you select based on that. Story based essays or lessons. Essays are story based lessons. That is easy for you to understand or easy to remember. That's why I ask you to select story based lessons. What are the story based lesson? As I told you, lion and the lamb or lady and the tiger. So these are all the prose lessons. So from prose, you can select two from the prose. And poetry. Solitary ripper, gift. Oh, what is that sound? Ode to the West Wind. So these are all the four poetry you have. In that, solitary ripper, again you studied in your early classes. And that you can select. And gift is a very small poem that you can select. So from that also, Ode to the West Wind, it's a difficult poem, it's a literary based poem, and Oh What Is That Sound is also a kind of difficult poem. So gift and solitary ripper, as you studied in the early class, okay, that you can select. So two essays, four essays. So how many remaining? So four, two plus two, five. So five got over, remaining three essays. So from short story, from one act play, you can select any three stories. Fortune teller, postmaster, modern millionaire, adventures of the dying leader. Fortune teller, postmaster, modern millionaire. Again, modern millionaire, you studied in your early classes, that you can select. It's a story based. Postmaster, or short stories or story based one. Story based lessons. That is a very important clue I am giving you now. You can select that kind of story based lessons to study, which is very easy to write. You can write your own stories. Your own stories in the sense, you can write of your own. Even if you are not able to write the literary based language, so that and all, no need. Okay. So simple stories, the summary of the story. So that kind of lesson you select. In that, short stories, fortune teller, postmaster, modern millionaire, you can select these three stories. Dying detective also you can select, but it is some difficult. Those who have find it difficult in language. Again, in one act plays, we have Dept.of, the dear departed, very easy story, very comic one. And Sheriff Kitchen, the anniversary. Sheriff Kitchen and dear departed is a compulsory question, it's a repeated question that you can select in that. So see, how many essays are there? 4, 3, 7, 9, 5, 4, 9 plus 1, 10 essays are there. Okay, fine. So 10 essays, I asked you to study only 8 essays. But if you study this method, you can study 8 essays very easily. All are story based lessons. Why I ask you to select story based one? It's easy to remember the sequence, the characters and the events. So if you remember like a cinema, you can easily write the essays. Okay, so how many pages you have to write the essays? 2 pages you have to write the essays. And paragraph in your exam, that means, as you know, that your examination paper answer sheet, half pages or 1 page is more than enough for 5 mark question. Okay, fine. And essay, 2 pages. Or if you are good at languages, you can write 3 pages also. 2 or 3 pages also. But 2 pages if you write is enough. Okay, so the stories. Okay, remember the story. For example, Lady of the Tiger. So remember, there is a semi-barbaric king and he has a daughter and she fell in love with a boy who is working in their palace. You can see this kind of stories in so many Tamil cinemas. You can relate that and that you can write the story. Okay, so how, what is happening, and the daughter's father, the semi-barbaric, who is semi-barbaric? He is an uncivilized one. Uncivilized means he doesn't know how to segregate the things properly. So his daughter, he fell in love with a man who is working. He belongs to very low category. So he doesn't like his daughter fell in love with that boy. So that is the problem with that man. And he's a semi boy. He's uncivilized, uncultured. He doesn't understand the love chemistry between the boy and the girl. So he wanted to punish that boy. He had a he prepared an arena in that he punished the people. How he punished the people? By making two doors. One door consists of a lion, a very ferocious lion. The other one is a lady. Okay? If the accused is a man, the other one is accused is a man, the other one is a lady. Opposite. Like that. He prepared a two doors like that, and the accused one, he has to open the door. Okay, depends upon his luck. And if you open the door of lion, the lion is very ferocious one, immediately he made it that the accused one made into pieces. And if the man, if he opens the door of a lady, immediately he gets married. Okay, he gets married with that lady, and he can easily lead a very happy life. That's why he called the king is called semi-barbaric, uncivilized. This kind of judgment he is giving to the one who commits mistake. So he wanted to do the same thing to the one who fell in love with his daughter also. But the writer, what is the end of the story? It's called open-ended story. Why it is called open-ended story? Because there is no end to the story. Open-ended story. What is open-ended story? No end to the author, the writer. He didn't give any end to the story. So you have to write the story. The man, okay, so imagine the lion is here, the lady is here, and the one who fell in love with the his daughter is here. If you open the lady, he will get married. Okay, so now you have to decide, depends upon the lover, that is the daughter, the princess, the daughter or the princess. So princess is a lady, and she is a princess, and she is a daughter of a king, and she has power. So all those things, and she fell in love with the man. So all those things you have to keep it in your mind, and based on that only you have to give the end of the story. So it's an open-ended story. You have all the rights to give the end to the story like an author. So this kind of stories you have to select it. Why? Because you can write the story of your own. So just get the theme and write your own. So like the story-based essays you select. Story-based essays, Lion and the Lamb, Lady and the Tiger, and Fortune Teller. Fortune Teller, again a very important, very interesting story. Okay, end of third day, the one who goes to find out the accused fell in love, that means eloped with that person. Okay, so that is a kind of stories. And Postmaster, Modern Millionaire, again a very interesting story which you already studied in your early classes. Okay, so these are all the way. So what is that? So art students, very easy. Arms and the Man, it's a compulsory question. You have to study that. Very interesting story. At least study the summary, both the essay question and the paragraph question. The last question from the last question is from Arms and the Man. Okay, from paragraph and essay. So it's a compulsory question. And out of 16, you are going to study only 7. So we have an option here, 9 stories. Okay, so out of 9 stories, what type of stories you have to select? You have to select only story-based lessons. Story-based lessons like Lady or the Tiger or the Postmaster or Model Millionaire, this kind of stories. They are departed, very interesting story. So this kind of stories, if you select story-based, okay. So cinema, imagine that, relate that, any kind of cinemas, and write the story. So like that you select, okay. So this is the first part of your thing, that is select story-based story. 8 essays, let me say 8 essays, easy to get through your exams. And now we move on to one word questions. One word, how many one word you have? 15 one word questions or one mark question. 15 one mark questions are here. Okay, this is common to both. This is the same thing for science students also. What is the difference between CLSR 2L students, that is science student, microbiology, biotechnology, computer science, EM, discom students. So what is the difference between CLSR 2K and 2L? 2L students, you don't have arms and the man. Instead of that, out of 16 questions, you have to study 8 or 10 question, the same way story based lessons. As I told you, refugee, lion in the lamb, like that you select it. Okay, so like that you select. So as you don't have arms and the man is a compulsory question to the art students, become students. Okay, 16 out of 16 lesson, any 8 to 10 story based lessons. Okay, that is the one. And one more question, very easy. Try to attend all the questions. That is very important. Attend all the one mark question. That is very, very important. What is attend all the question and whatever, all the not only one mark question, other question also. It is, for example, in the corrections, for example, you are getting only 25 marks out of 30. If the examiner, they find that where are the places to give remaining 5 marks. If you attend all the question only, then give okay. So paragraph question, he has written nicely, okay, 2 plus 1. Let them give. So like that, all the question, 5 mark or so, he has attended all the 5 paragraph question. He has attended all the 10 mark question. Okay, let it be. 25, make it into 30. Like that, you will get marks. Okay, so attend all the questions. That is very, very important in your university exams. Don't become lazy and write only few questions and leave the exam hall. Don't do that. Attend all the questions, especially one mark question. You will get one mark question, propositions, article question you have, and adjective, ordering the adjective. It's all very easy. And phrasal, two phrasal questions you have, phrasal verb questions and verbs, choose the verb questions, modal auxiliary verb questions. So all those questions and all, you just attend. Modal auxiliary verbs and all, you just put will, shall, this, anyone you just put. Even if you don't know the answer, proper answer, exact answer, you just put, read the question properly and think your why, then put the answer. Okay, so attend all the one mark question, that is very, very important, and essay question and the paragraph question also select story based lessons. Okay, story based lessons, compare with any stories and imagine the, that is keep it in mind, the characters, the sequence, the events. Okay, so all those things, the order. Okay, so this is happening first and then this and then this, like this order. Okay, keep it in mind, all those things in your mind, and write. How to write? Don't, if you think in mind, because we are all thinking in Tamil, our mother tongue, then we find difficult to read, that means translate into English. So for that difficulty, to avoid that difficulty, what we have to do, just to read the essay. You all have with the, you are all have the summary with you. Okay, get it from your English teacher and keep it in hand. Read it loudly. Okay, line and the law, summary. Read it very loudly, or else go through the text. Read the text properly 2-3 times. 2-3 times if you read it, then it will be easy for you. Okay, so attend all the question. That is the one point, very important point. Attend all the question. That is the first one. So what you have to do, the first one, first point, what is that? Selection. What type of question you have to select? Story based lesson you have to select. Second one, what is the second one you have to do? Attend all the question. Don't leave any question. Attend all the question and don't write, if that means stories. Like this of, was, this kind of, no, without any connections, no, don't write rubbish. Okay, so don't give room for the examination to irritate. Okay, don't make them to irritate, right? Neatly, whatever you know related to the story. So like that, these are all the things you have to do. If you do, if you attend all the question, you can easily get through the papers. So this is the first part for the general English. This is the same thing for second, this is for first year. For second year also. Second year, this is the last semester, CLSR 4R, last semester easy to get through. Again, you have 4 into 5, 20, and 4 into 10, 40, and 3 5 mark question based on your writing skills. In that you will get precise writing, note making, letter writing, paraphrasing, and comprehension. So these are all the questions. Out of 5, you will get any 3 questions. Okay, so out of this, any 3 questions, most probably comprehension, precise writing, paraphrasing. So compulsory question, and very important thing, sometimes you will get precise writing or note making. My dear students, I just want to tell you, don't repeat or don't copy what is given in precise and note making as your essay question. This is my humble request to you. That is very badly affect your result. How would very badly affect your result? For example, one essay question. My dear students, you are good at this technique, I know that, but don't repeat that, please. Okay, don't repeat that. What you used to do means, in essay question, very good, you are good at, you write, put the question number and you write the question also. And what you used to do, nicely you copy what is there in the question paper, precise writing and note making, they will give a passage. Precise writing, they will give a lengthy passage, and that you have to make it into brief, short. That is mean by precise writing. Precise means short, crisp. Okay, very precisely you have to make it. So they will give a lengthy passage. That lengthy passage, you have to make it into brief. For example, if they give 3 paragraph, you have to make it into 1 paragraph. Okay, so note making also, they will give one lengthy paragraph, that you have to make it into hints type and or main points. Only main points you have to write, give the title also. But what our brilliant students do, he exactly copy what is there in precise writing and note making as your answer here essays, and you believe that those who are correcting your papers are fools. Okay, don't do that. That irritates the examiners. Don't do that. Simply study as I am going to, that is story based lessons, and write the essays. Don't write precise and note making in the essays. That reduce, that definitely reduce, that definitely affects your results. So 4 paragraph, 4 essays, 3 5 mark question. Very simple method, I tell you. If you write 5 paragraph question, minimum marks is 1 paragraph is 2 marks. Minimum marks is essay is 3 marks. So imagine 3 into 4, 3 into 5. 10 mark question, 10 marks, 12 marks. If you attend this question, 3. So how many? 22 plus 9, 31 marks. This is the easiest method to get. How much you have to get? 30 you have to get it. So out of 30, 31 easily you can get. How can you get that? You attend the question properly without cheating the exam. Okay, without cheating yourself also. Study any questions. In your examination also, second year also, you have story based questions. Okay, so many story based questions are there. Little girls are wiser than men, and lost clock, and Merchant of Venice and what is called Julius Caesar. This and all you studied in your earlier classes also. Okay, Merchant of Venice you studied in your earlier classes. And how far is the river? How far is the river? And what is else? Old Man River. And what else? Fiver George. And Bishop Candlesticks. So like that, any 10 essays you study. Okay, so how many essays you have to write? 5 plus 4 plus 4, 8 essays you have to study. Okay, so after 8, you just study 10 essays. So Julius Caesar, Merchant of Venice, qualities of mercy, very important question. Merchant of Venice, you studied in earlier classes, you can easily learn that. Okay, and Julius Caesar, Only two questions. Antony's speech and Brutus' speech. Antony's, how Antony's speech? How Brutus? Very simple. Brutus, he has only three reasons why he killed Julius Caesar. And Antony, he has so many reasons. All are what is called very emotional. Okay, so how our politicians takes the people in their hands by speaking very emotionally, by persuading. So this is the way Antony's speech. Okay, so Antony, how Antony's speech? So he wanted, he says that that is, I came here, that means not to praise Caesar, to bury Caesar. Actually, he wanted to praise Caesar, not bury Caesar. Okay, he used to say that Brutus is an honorable man, he is an ambitious man, seven times he says. But what is the actual purpose of Antony? He wanted to take revenge over the death of his friend Julius Caesar. So that's seven reasons. Okay, so that's seven reasons by Antony and three reasons by Brutus. That's all. Okay, compare the speeches of Julius, Brutus and Antony. Simple essay. And budget of Venice, very simple essay. How Portia says the qualities of mercy from Shylock. You can see more number of Shylocks in our day-to-day life. Moneylenders. Okay, how these moneylenders are, what is called, getting money and how they are treating the people. So these are all the things happening here. Okay, so he wanted to, the pound of flesh which is very close to the heart of what is called Antony. How is it possible to take the pound of flesh, exactly 1 pound? This is the eloquence. Portia, how she wins over the case Shylock? Because of the eloquence. What is meant by eloquence? The power of word. Okay, so she used the words power of the words. She says 2 points, only 2 points she said. That is exactly 1 pound he has to cut. Is it possible to cut exactly? If I ask to cut, okay, you cut exactly half kg from my hand. Is it possible exactly cut half kg from my hand? It is not at all possible. But what is there in the Shylock ball? 1 pound you have to cut. So that is the one. It is not possible to cut exactly 1 pound. That is the 1 point she says. And what is the second point she said? Not even a drop of Christian blood. Not even a drop of Christian blood. What is meant by Christian blood? Antony is a Christian. Shylock is a Jew. That's why. Not even a drop of Christian blood. Which is not there in the bond. What is there in the bond? Within 3 months you have to repay the amount. Otherwise, I will take a pound of flesh which is very exact, which is very close to Antonio's heart. Okay? That is the one he says. But while cutting the pound of flesh, is it possible without shedding a blood? You can cut it? It is not possible. But that is not mentioned in Shylock Bond. So this is the power of eloquence and brilliance. These are the 2 points she says. Very simple story. This we studied in our earlier classes. And Julius Caesar. Last class, very interesting story. Little girls are wiser than men. How far is the river? Very simple stories. And very important thing, one more story. Ant and the grasshopper. Ant and the grasshopper. These are all we study in your earlier classes. We know, we can see in our cartoon channels. Okay, that based on that only, but how it is differently told by the author. That's all. So these are all story based story. That's why I used to tell story based story. For example, if I asked you to write one story is there in your list, Urzal Flummery. The name itself very difficult to pronounce this. But that story is very difficult. I never asked you to study that story because it's very difficult to remember the story or the character, the sequence and all. So don't select that kind of stories. Select only this kind of story based stories. We have so many, more than 10 stories. How many stories we have to study? Only 8 stories. So these are all the tips you have to follow to get through your exams very easily. First year students as well as second year students. First year students, as I told you, so two categories, science and arts. Okay, so select only story based questions, 1 mark also. Don't leave any question, attend all the questions. Okay, write neatly, give your presentation neatly. Okay, and second year students also select story based questions and attend all the 3 questions. Okay, which is the paraphrasing, precise writing, note making, comprehension. Any 3 questions they will give, attend all the questions. And all the very best for my dear students to get through your exams, this forthcoming semester examinations. Thank you all.